Hello guys! Welcome and welcome back to my channel. And of course, kung bago ka sa channel na to, please subscribe and hit the notification bell para lagi kang updated sa mga videos na i-upload ko. And for today's video, i-share ko sa inyo ang mga corrections natin sa BCLTE Review Number 2. And this is BCLTE Review Number 9. Nakaraang video natin, BCLTE Review Number 2, ay may mga corrections po tayo. Nag-aapura na siya. Alright, may mga correction po tayo and hindi po natin yun sinasadya. At i-correct po natin ito ngayon. And may mga idadagdag po tayo na mga sections kung saan nanggaling yung ating questions. Ayan. Malapit na ang exam, so huwag kayong mag-alala. May ilang araw pa tayo para mapaghandaan natin itong June 11, 2023 BCLTE. Ayan. Sige, start na tayo. Number 1, yung tinatanong dito, ilan daw ang recommendees? Kinakailangan na irerekomenda ni mayor or ni governor para sa appointment ng treasurer. Of course, ang sagot dito ay 3, at least 3. Ayan. Saan naman ito matatagpuan? Ayan. Mababasa natin ito sa Chapter 2, Book 1 ng LTOM, Qualifications and Appointment of the Local Treasurer and the Assistant Treasurer. Ayan. Section 4, Authority of the Secretary of Finance to appoint local treasurer and assistant treasurer. Ayan. Paragraph B, makikita nyo at least 3 ranking eligible recommendees of the governor or mayor. Dako tayo sa question number 2, the following are some of the requirements for the appointment of a local treasurer. Ayan. Except, siyempre, si Certified Public Accountant. Kasi tingnan natin, wala naman tayong makikitang Certified Public Accountant dyan sa mga qualifications na yan, mababasa natin sa Section 6 pa rin ng LTOM, Book 1, Chapter 2. Ayan. Number 3, delegation of the appointing authority over provincial, city, and municipal treasurer and their assistants may be given by the Secretary of Finance to BLGF Executive Director. Ayan. Section 4 naman natin ito mababasa. Authority of the Secretary of Finance to appoint local treasurer and assistant treasurer. Ayan. Designated, delegated authority of the BLGF Regional Director to designate, subject to the confirmation pa rin naman ng Secretary of Finance. Pero pagdating po sa Metro Manila, si Secretary of Finance pa rin ang mag-a-appoint. Number 4, request for relief. Ayan, transfer or detail of treasurer and assistant treasurer. Alin daw dyan yung hindi kasama doon sa mga justifiable reason para sa transfer, relief, and detail of treasurer and the assistant treasurer. Termination of the formal investigation. Ayan po, makikita nyo po yan sa Section 8, Paragraph D, yung requirements for relief. Tatlo lang naman yan. Eh. Ang makikita natin, existing final audit, finding of cost shortage. Ayan. Properly validated by the regional director. The treasurer has been formally charged with grave offense and the treasurer consent. Okay. Number 5, unless, ito, medyo nirevise po natin yung question na to. Very tricky kasi yung question doon sa BCLTE Review Number 2 natin. Unless sooner revoked, the extension of designation of an acting or OIC provincial, city, municipal treasurers shall be the period of 6 months po. Ayan. Tingnan natin sa section 8, paragraph 8, paragraph F. Ayan. Medyo nauutal na naman po ako. Pasensya na po. Medyo nag-aapura po tayo. Extension of designation as acting or OIC provincial, municipal treasurer, and acting or OIC assistant treasurer. Ayan. Makikita natin dito, each extension of designation shall be for a period of 6 months unless sooner revoked. Makikita natin dito sa section 8 pa rin, paragraph E, yung period of designation para naman sa permanent vacancy and temporary vacancy. Ayan, basahin nyo po yan, yung paragraph na yan, nakalagay po dyan, for a non-extendable period of 1 year unless sooner revoked. Ayan, may mga exemption din po dyan. Basahin nyo po. Ayan. And, ayan, ipaprocess naman ni regional office yung designation and extensions within 15 days. 15 days. Ayan. Balik tayo. Parang hindi nagbabak. Alright. Ayan, number 6 na tayo. Ito nga, shall be processed by the regional office within 15 days. Paragraph G. Basahin po natin. Mababasa niyo sa paragraph G, processing and submission of designation within 15 days from the issuance of the order. Number 7, isasubmit naman the regional office yung designation and extension and shall be confirmed within 15 days pa rin. Paragraph H, mababasa ninyo ito sa paragraph H, confirmation of designation by the Secretary of Finance within 15 days from receipt thereof. Question number 8, an official or employee designated by proper authority to discharge fully the powers and responsibility as head of the provincial, city, or municipal treasury office as a result of prerogatives of the latter except the right to receive the salary appurtenant thereto. Sagot po natin dyan is acting treasurer. And dito naman yung may an official or employee designated by proper authority in a temporary capacity to avert paralyzation of the day-to-day operation of the office in the meantime that the provincial, city, or municipal treasurer is temporary absent. Ano naman tawag natin dyan? Officer in charge. Ayan. Mababasa nyo po ito sa section 9. Distinction of designation as acting treasurer and officer in charge or OIC and acting treasurer assistant treasurer. Ayan. So basahin niyo po yan, section 9. Yung distinction po ng OIC and acting treasurer. Question number 10, the municipal or the assistant municipal treasurer who automatically assumes as ICO or in charge of office shall notify the BLGF regional director concerned through the provincial treasurer of the absence, sickness, death of other incapacity of the regular incumbent and of the date of his her assumption in a caretaker capacity within 24 hours. Ayan. 24 hours. Ayan. Section 10. Makikita nyo po ayan yung automatic succession of the assistant provincial, city, municipal treasurer as acting OIC, ICO, provincial, city, municipal treasurer. Ayan po. Paragraph B, papabasa niyo po. 24 hours. Ayan, medyo ano po tayo, no? Ayan, sa paragraph B, ayan. And sa paragraph C, within 48 hours dapat ay after receipt of the notice, the BLGF regional director shall issue the order of designation of the said official treasurer subject to the confirmation of the Secretary of Finance. Question number 11, the approval of application for leave. Ayan, ito naman. O provincial, city, and municipal. Sino daw nag-a-approve ng leave? Ayan, si depart sa provincial, city, and municipal treasurer. Ayan. Where he intends to leave the country regardless of duration shall be by the Department of Finance. E papaano naman? Ayan, mababasa niyo yan sa section 15. Approval and grant of application for leave of absence of local treasurer and assistant local treasurer. Papaano naman si assistant provincial, city, municipal treasurer for a period exceeding 15 days shall be approved naman ni BLGF regional director. Ayan, mababasa niya sa paragraph D, application for leave of assistant municipal treasurer, assistant provincial, city, municipal treasurer for a period exceeding 15 days. Alright. Maraming salamat po at dito na po nagtatapos ang ating BCLTE review number 9. Abangan nyo po yung mga susunod pa nating i-upload na video para po sa mga magtitake ng BCLTE ngayong June 11, 2023. Maraming salamat! Bye-bye!